Alright guys, what's going on? So, instead of do a video, I haven't done any videos in the last week or two, primarily because I've been on my iPad primarily, and I've been unable to record videos on my iPad, which hopefully soon I'll be able to change, because... But, an update came out for Ultimate General Civil War, where you can actually play on your Mac. They made the Mac component available, so... I wanted to give it a try, see what's going on. So it gives me a couple of battles here. Chancellorsville, Stonesville River, Antietam, second battle, Malvern Hill, Gaines Mill. This is kind of cool because Malvern Hill and Gaines Mill are like not too far from my house. But let us play Battle of Chancellorsville. Let's see. Confederate will be cool. Alright. So let's see this. I haven't been able to, I didn't play this yet. The Chancellorsville battle. I'm hoping to give the whole battle. I don't have to go through like little steps here. Yes. Just skip all this. I don't want a tutorial. Skip. Alright. I gotta say, I mean, every time I play this game, I always get amazed by the graphics on this. It's beautiful. I mean, attention to the detail is just incredible. So this is Jackson. I assume I'm going around the flank of the Union. Just gotta figure out which way the map is oriented. Alright. That's cavalry. Fitz Lee, I believe, right? And this is Jackson with at least a brigade. Another one here. Is that where the house is? I know there's a house. Name Chancellorsville Crossing, I believe. Probably here, I think. I'm trying to remember off my visiting the battlefield number of times. I think this is it. Because I remember there's a southern road. I remember. Yeah, this is probably it. I remember the Union Army was camped here. Yeah, this is it. I remember the house looked like this, and there was a kind of like a shed here. So, okay. So I guess this is not the whole battlefield. Because Jackson attacks somewhere here. So I have to go in steps again. Damn, that sucks. Alright, whatever. That bloody sucks. Alright, so First Corps. And I know that there's going to be some skirmishing here and here. Jackson has 10,000 men. How about that? That's a lot of men. I love the animations in the background. You can hear like the audio. Alright. Second Corps Jackson. That doesn't look like Jackson though. Kind of looks more like a Yule, I would say. I don't know. Alright. Let's go. Speed up. Who is that, Law? No, that's Lee. General Lee. Alright, so they're bringing out a brigade. Are they double timing? Alright. So, I'm trying to figure out what we're going to do here. Because I'm assuming I have to go here, right? And take that road. Head here. I'm gonna keep you in reserve. Get the guns up. If my personal recommendation, if you guys have never been to Virginia, I currently live in Virginia. I'm from Brooklyn. But one beautiful thing about living in Virginia is that it's just loaded with Civil War battlefields. I mean, the Civil War was Virginia in essence. I mean, for the most part, I'm not like putting down anything that happened in the West, because obviously Shiloh is a big battle and battle that I'm very interested in. Chickamauga and Chattanooga and all that, those are huge massive battles. However, I mean, if the war was pretty much decided in the East, you know. The West was kind of, I in my opinion, I mean, I'm trying to figure out a good word that I can use. The West was pretty much, I'm not going to say diversion. I'll leave one brigade here. I'm not going to say diversion, but the West was more of a... see, shoot. Let's see if we can go into the woods here. It was a supporting element, I guess. The West was kind of like a supporting element in the Civil War. Even if Vicksburg, you know, a lot of people say Vicksburg was the key to the Confederacy. And, you know, I mean, it was important because supplies are going from Texas to the Confederate Army, was feeding them. But if Richmond fell, if Lee kind of fell apart, you know, the war would have pretty much ended. If Richmond was taken, Lee wasn't head of the army, let's say 1862, 7 days battle, Union took Richmond, smashed the army in Northern Virginia, pretty much the war would have been over then. So, and if Lee won or surrounded D.C., it would have given a great deal of political, I guess, capital, political money, in terms of how the European powers looked upon the Confederacy. Because, I mean, if you capture the United States capital, that would be a huge thing. So, I guess in this game, what I'm trying to do is I'm going to use this brigade. Whose brigade is this? 2nd Division of the 1st Corps. I'm going to use them as kind of like a way to kind of let these guys go through. So, any forces that are coming from the east, they can easily transverse this. Oh, no, no, no. Don't go that far. I should actually maintain that. Hold. How bad? And, you know, a lot of people have been... Wolf's Brigade is also here. Hurry, don't let them... Okay, whatever. But in essence, I mean, one of the... My favorite games that I like playing is Scourge of War, because it kind of, like I was saying in a previous podcast that I do with Historical Gamer, it kind of just gives you the map and says, hey, here are the forces, have at it, and you can kind of do any kind of battle that you want. You know, you can press Jackson's forces in the middle of the night, try to destroy the Union Army in detail. You're not kind of, like in this game, you're kind of... I'm trying to find a good word for it, but you're kind of like escorted through the battle. You know, you somebody's holding your hand. You know, you're not. I have to first finish whatever here. I have to hold the Orange Turnpike and a plank road. I can't develop any overarching plans. Like the forces in Fredericksburg, obviously I don't have command of them. I don't have command of the full Confederate army. Right, I only have command of so far 14,000 out of I think it was like 35,000-40,000. So, and they give it to you piecemeal, and eventually at one point you'll get the full army, right, in this game, but you're not going to be able to do your own strategies, you know. Once this board is over, or this level, it's going to move on to the next level, which will be the flanking maneuver. And which, you know, some people are fine with that, you know, by all means, but the problem that I have with it is... Well, I like doing my own thing, you know? I'm trying to figure out if there's another road. No, that's the only road. So I'm going to position you guys there. Where's this cannon? Put the cannon here. Who's this? Alright. Alright, so I'm going to move the second core, the third division of the second core here, and they're going to be my flanking maneuver. Halston is entering the battle. We outnumber them. Attack. Wow, this is a lot of units here. Not going to attack, my friend. There is a method to my madness. Everybody goes here. Whoa, look at that. It's like a snake. What up? Hold on. How do I get them to face this? What? How is this? All right, hold on. There we go. Much better. All right, so I'm moving the entire second corps to three divisions. Damn, that's a lot of divisions. 30,000 men. And Lee's only gonna have 14,000. Damn, this is cool. All right, I gotta admit, this is cool. So I'm gonna have a reserve here, this guy. This guy is going to be my reserve. I'm going to bring the artillery. Here, I guess. And I'm going to use these guys to make sure nobody's crossing. So this is kind of a good plan, right? I mean, I have about 15,000 men, gonna hold them off, which I think is enough. I have 700 men here, it's not a lot. Holding my extreme right flank, 1,800 men here, 2,000 men here, another 2,000, supported by some artillery, and I have the entire second corps, a full 30,000 men to do as I wish. I think this is the most viable artillery. I was actually at this road right here, at the marker where Jackson and Lee actually sat. Took a couple of photos. Maybe I'll throw them in this video here. It was an incredible scene. I mean, you see the actual paintings of Jackson and Lee under the tree, and then, you know, I get to actually stand or sit right there where they were so many years back. It's very amazing. Wait, we are winning. I'll never push them back. Journalists advise not advance too much near the campus. Why is it not let me select that? So it wants me to attack here. I don't want to attack. See, that's the problem. Like, you have to do what the bloody game tells you to do. It's like, hey, attack here. And it's just like, I don't want to attack there. I want to kind of start the maneuver already. You know, it's 1,300, you know? Or I want to do something here. It's telling me attack here. Maybe I want to take the forces and come up this way. You know, like, I don't like being told what to do. Maybe it's just, you know, the Brooklyn side of me, you know, like, I don't know. I don't get it. And maybe that's why I probably never got that high up in the military, because I have a mouth on me. But I like doing what I like doing. You know, I want to do my own thing. And I want to, I call it, go this way. I don't want to do what you're telling me to do, is just go that way. I probably wouldn't be a good I'd probably only be good as like general in chief. As a soldier, I a hard time not listening, but I don't know. One cool thing is, you know, when you're working for a big company like Apple, they thrive on you kind of saying, well, I like doing it. I'd rather do it this way. You know, I think we should do it this way. And they kind of thrive a little bit on it, not 100%, but they welcome it a little bit more. Just a little bit. Look at this. I love this. They put textures on here to mark where the artillery hit. That's pretty cool. Not a lot of games do that. The only thing is, there's only a certain amount that they could put here before the actual game is, you know, before like the graphics engine can't keep up with it because there's too much crap on the game. So I guess I have to do what they say, otherwise I'm not gonna go to the next right step. Sucks, man. Maybe I can do it with just what's just this division here. Move forward. I'm gonna move the reserve. I only need another 1,800 men. I can do what they want me to do with a fraction of the forces. That's right, I'm coming. Look at that. They withdrew. They routed my first volley. How bad. Man, this brigade took a heavy loss, Rosses. So I have literally. Oh, they're forming up again. Are you running? No, they're not running. It looks like they're running, right? Alright, start moving up. I'm gonna have you guys start moving here. Gain that road. The interesting thing about this game is, like, I don't want to touch the second core because these men are 100%, right? And I want the full 30,000 for the flank maneuver. If I use them now and I reduce that number down to like 25,000, it's 5,000 less troops that I have for the overall battle. Come on, engage them. Get those guns up. Start moving. Ooh, look at that. They withdrawn. How many forces did I put? Oh crap, now they got their guns up. It's okay. It's okay. I gotcha. And you just need to hug the river and make sure nobody's there. Let's move up. Union's kind of weak. They only put like a brigade forward. I was expecting more. 120,000 men. I think it was 120,000 men, right? If I'm not mistaken. That the Union had. I got the whole second corps sitting here. So nice. So nice. See, like right now, what I would like be doing if I actually had the whole map, I would start moving the artillery forward while these guys rested. I would just have the artillery keep moving west. There's no point in doing that because the AI, the game's gonna do that for me, so it's worthless. You know, I think tonight I'm probably gonna do another video on Scourge of War, Chancellorsville, and kind of gonna give you like the pros and cons of both. Because honestly, I love when Oh, they got a nice line going here on this stone wall. It's okay. I got you. I got you real nice. Bring up the bloody artillery. That's cute. They got a stone wall. I got the real stone wall. Come on, shoot. Damn, he's wide and open. Fire. Guard my flank like that, and you are going to be my. You got nothing. I mean, it's like a brigade. What is wrong with them? It's like 1% of the actual force that they have. Damn, they're shooting me already? Damn it. Not good. Not good, my friend. Get those cannons up already. Come on. There we go. That should rattle them. Shoot, man. Stand by. I gotta put some forces up here. I don't want to commit my reserve yet. Make sure nobody is good. I want you to hold my right flank. That's all you're going to do, my friend. Bring supplies up. Where's Lee? Lee to help my guys out. So within sight of the Chancellorsville house. Come on, hit him! Oh, it's not a stone wall, it's just a fence. That should rip him up a little bit. Bring the guns up here. Dude, I'm pushing the Union back. You have 120,000 men. Seriously? Come on, get some cojones. Oh man, those guns, man. They got one, two. They got three artillery batteries, man. It's not cool. I got one. Maybe I should borrow some from the bloody Second Corps. Yeah, I think I'm gonna borrow some artillery batteries. No offense, guys, I need some artillery. I'll give you back later. Actually, the game will do give it back to you later. Bring up three. Damn it! Wilcox got routed. I left his flank open. That was a stupid mistake. And he's out of ammo. Almost out. Dude, get the supplies up there. Move your... Frackin'... Ah, ya son of a biatch. We're not ready. Get into the woods. Double time. How bad are you hit? Damn, he's getting hit bad. Once Wilcox gains his I'm gonna flank these suckers. I'm gonna risk my right flank, move 700 men along Wilcox, and then we're gonna go around them. Hit them here, see if I can collapse them. They're probably gonna use this stream as like an anchor point. That's what I would do. Damn it, dude. Why is my guns not... Move, move, move. How is the cover? It's another cool thing in this game. They'll tell you how much cover a unit has. How much cover do you have? Give me a number. I'm gonna move you back just in case. Damn, we're taking heavy losses. Fallback. Oh, crap. I said withdraw, don't rout. I'm gonna move Wilford here. Dude, get your shit together. Move Lee to my right flank. Gotta make sure my right flank is secure. But... Alright, so yeah, he is anchored here. He put some forces here as a... We cannot advance further. That's right. I'm coming out of the woods. I got two brigades hitting him. Roughly 2,500 men. Damn, it's not even two times the force. I need another man. I'm gonna use him. See, this is one thing I don't like, man. This is not cool. Proceed to the next day. So I guess the whole thing that... Yeah, not cool. Alright, whatever. It's like right in the middle of that. You know, like things were getting hot. I was doing a flanking maneuver now. Like, what's going on now? So the chances of crossing, which is where I was, everybody moved back. This is like the one thing I hate. Like, it... Whatever. It is what it is. So this is the one big failing of the game that I really don't like, and I'm not cool with that at all, is like all that stuff that I was doing. I was going to flank him on this river. I was sending three brigades at him. I could have probably turned and actually maybe even had, like, you know, surrounded this Chancellorsville crossing and maybe actually changed the strategy of Chancellorsville. But no, I have to now do this. I have to do the legit historical thing of Jackson's flanking maneuver, which is fine. But, you know, it was a great maneuver. But I want to do my own thing. I don't understand why this is it. You know, I don't get it. At this point, I'm kind of like pissed off enough to play the game. So I hope you guys enjoy the Chancellorsville scenario. I'm kind of too pissed off right now to kind of be like, continue playing. Because if I play this scenario, this level, and I get somewhere good or I change up the scenario, it's gonna fast forward it to something else. So yeah, I'm not even bothering. I'll save this and maybe I'll come back to it, but I'm gonna do another video like right after this and hopefully post it the same day of Scourge of War Chancellorsville and kind of comparing the two. So hopefully stay tuned to the next video. So the one cool thing about this is how epic this thing is, man. I mean, it doesn't have the graphics. Oh, this is cool. All division commanders received their maps and orders in the cave. Oh, beautiful, thank you. Wow, that's sick. I mean, look at the scope of this. I mean, it doesn't have the graphics that you have in, is it Westwork? Yes, it does. As Ultimate General Civil War does. I mean, the graphics here are not the greatest. They're good, don't get me wrong. They're really good. I mean, you can obviously tell what everything is, and everything looks beautiful. Screenshot capable, you know, I'm going to take a screenshot of that. So, I mean, I would say probably 70-80% of the graphics quality that you get from Ultimate General Civil War. In terms of just looking at it like that. But it's honestly, it's the scope of the game. I mean, look how huge this is. I have full access to this whole map, dude. To the whole map here, I have full access to it. So... I mean, they're already moving. I have a full command of 37,199 men. I can do whatever I want. I'm trying to figure out what I want to do. I can jump through. Oh, this is cool. Okay, first core. All right. Damn, I can do a lot of things on this game here. All right, so those are the Alabama regiments. I assume this is Jackson's kind of thing. This is Chancellorsville crossing. So I can go here. So Jackson's attacking Chancellorsville, the left flank. And then I got Union in front of me. There's that house. Right? And some Union regiments here. Oh, crap. I keep screwing that up. I keep using the arrow keys, and I'm not supposed to be using arrow keys. Alright. All right, so here are my forces. Union forces are right over here. So Jackson's beginning his attack. So what I can do, help him out, I can take this brigade and push them forward. Line. I can even go to... The one cool thing that Ultimate General has is a lot easier way of kind of going up the command structure. Because like right now I have this brigade. I'm moving them into position. Damn, I keep doing that. Keep using the bloody arrow keys. I don't know why I keep doing that. So I have this brigade moving, but I want to get the division commander for that brigade I'm moving here. And also, like, when you click on the unit, like, you can't click on the soldiers. You have to actually click on the flag, and obviously that's not easy. All right, there we go. So I have to, if I want to find the whole McClaws, if I want to find McClaws, I actually have to find McClaws. You know, I can't just click here, you know. That's the only thing that I always have trouble with this game. I usually had to come down here and say, all right, where are you, McClaws? There you go. Is this McClaws? No, this is Mahone. But he, Mahone's brigade. Yeah, his brigade. Where's the bloody division commander? Is this him? No. See, this is the only thing that I had a problem with this in this game, man. Because I can't find this guy. I don't know if he's... in the back, you know, taking a couple of swigs of some vodka or whiskey. I know y'all Southerners don't have no vodka. You have some whiskey. I gotta admit, I love whiskey. I'm actually getting more preferential to whiskey than I am with vodka lately. Maybe it's the Virginia air, right? See, this is taking time right here. McClaws. I guess this is probably easier way to get. There we go. There's McClaws. Just hanging out in the background. Now I can't even see him. Where the heck is he? He's so far away, dude. Alright, so... And I guess the command and control is not as easy as Ultimate General Civil War. So both games can learn from each other, you know? I'm not saying either one's perfect. But the cool thing is like, I have full scope of this game right here. Union's here, I can say, you know what? There's probably some Confederates here. I can move into position. There's a division here under... Who's this guy? Mahone. Alright. So I'm going to move Mahone's brigade up here. And then I know Jackson is kind of doing his thing here. So if I had to kind of like compare both games, which one's more real to life, true to life, is definitely this game, by leaps and bounds. You know, they're in this scenario here, it's starting at 9 a.m. It's going to finish a long time away. It's going to take probably hours to finish this. But that's the beautiful thing about it. Patterson's Brigade. All right, let's hit them. Right? Where the heck? Oh, there it is. There they are. Right, hold on, which, facing east, yeah, so this is the Union Army. Line formation! I'm gonna hit them and rout them. And you can, I think, fast forward this too. So another cool thing that I like about this game is, if I recall, I can go up here, McCown's Brigade, go up high. How do I go up higher again? There we go. Robert E. Lee, Second Corps. All right, so Second Corps under, oh, this is after Jackson died? Because Second Corps is commanded by this guy. Yeah, I think this is after Jackson died, because it would say Jackson here. Huh, interesting. I know Stuart took command. So the cool thing I like about this is I can... I have Stuart here. Can I... No, there was a way you could. Yeah, you can kind of. All right, so I got a Heath here. And I'm going. I keep doing that, man. It's pissing me off. You do. Keep using the arrow keys, and I'm supposed to use west. Going east, there's the Union. And where's their thing? I think this is. I mean, obviously, the map could use some work. Let's cut them off here. I believe you can. There we go. Okay. There we go. And then by just doing that, I believe it's going to put all its units into action. So it's going to send out riders. Another cool thing about this game is it actually sends out riders. Like this guy, when I send him orders, he's gonna like have like 10 riders going out in every direction to send to division commanders, then to brigade commanders, and then to individual. So it's very realistic in that aspect. I really like that. Was about to do it again with the bloody arrow keys. There they are. Leaders can get also get killed here, so I gotta take this guy and put him behind the lines. So he's gonna do something stupid. As you can see here, I got these men forming up, and I can take individual command of these units. So the game, I mean, honestly, no offense, is so much epic in scope. If I had to like choose two game, if I had to choose one game between both, on which like if I only had, let's say $40 or $30, whatever it was, and both these games are the same price, I would choose this game honestly, because it would immerse me a great deal more into the battle. You know, Ultimate General Civil War is like, hey, you can replay the battles of Chancellorsville, but in these games here, you can actually change the nature of the battle here. Come on, go up. You're not gonna just stand in front of these things here. So, yeah, so you can actually change the dynamics of the battle. As you can see, I gave one of the orders to one of my division commanders, and he's going to go up here, try to take Humphreys. And he's actually doing that right now. He actually sent out the orders, and he's doing that on his own. I just told him where to go. I sent some forces here to engage the Union, and I could probably even go here and. Oh, damn, he's retreating. So it kind of. I can change the scope of the battle. I love that. You know, you can take these forces, move them around this right flank, and collapse here. In Ultimate General Civil War, you can't do that. I tried to, you know, as you can see in the last video, I tried to do something different and say, hey, you know what? Let me go after Chancellorsville Crossing, kind of put pressure there before I do another strategy. And then, you know, as soon as the marker, you know, the time limit came, it's like, all right, I'm gonna move all your forces back, and now you're gonna do this. It didn't even let me move the second corps to the right of the Union, you know. It did it for me, and it's just, you know, you need to charge, my friend. You need to charge. Gotta love that rebel yell. Look, I mean, this gives you so much of a scope. Oh, crap, I keep doing that shit. This pisses me off, man, that always happens. I don't know why I'm so used to bloody arrow keys. I think it's from the other games I play. But I mean, it gives you such an epic scope, but look how far these guys had to go. Now, you guys, I need you guys to come here. Look how long that field is, man. That's sick. And we just took a Confederate artillery position. I mean, a Union artillery position. Now, the cool thing is, in this game, you can actually... Damn, he got smashed. You can actually commandeer the Union artillery, and then they go to work for me. As you can see, I now have these guys here. Unions try to form up some forces. But I'm taking half their artillery. So obviously, you know, this is a big battle to, and I'm not going to play like 10 hours of this to kind of give you the whole thing. I'm just want to give you a little taste. Just in case some of you are trying to figure out, like, hey, which game should I buy? Which is really close to life Civil War game? No, stop. No, he's going to withdraw. I got some artillery. He's going to put some iron right in their face. But yeah, honestly, if you want a game that's more true to life, that's more authentic, this game, by far, leaps and bounds, man. You know, if Ultimate General Civil War just gave it a map and kind of said, hey, have at it, it would be a much tougher contest. Because the graphics there are a bit better. It's much more easier to control cores and divisions. Much more easier to control them. But, man, I can't, you know, honestly, when it kind of take, you know... Instead of it letting you fight the Battle of Chancellorsville, it says, all right, well, you're going to do this first, then you're going to do this, then you're going to do this. Oh, you want to fight the battle the way you want? No, that's not going to happen. That pisses me off. See here, these guys are engaging. You can tell who's winning here because I have about 475 men. Negative 21 means they took out. I lost 33 men, I believe. I'm sorry. I lost 53 men, and I believe this marks how many I took of them versus they took of me. The scoring system here is a little different. So I took 56 casualties, and I. Trying to figure out how this works. They took out 29 more of me than I did of them. So that's how that works. So obviously I'm losing. Oh crap. No. See, that's another thing that you have to actually click the flag, which is something I hate. Damn, he took heavy losses there. So I just wanted to guys give you a general rundown on how this game is. I mean, honestly, you know, I'm not saying it's the most beautiful Civil War game out there. I mean, a couple of things could be improved, like, you know, this background here and such. But one really cool thing about this game, it had a night mode as well as a day mode. So you can, some games literally start right in like morning where it's completely black. You can't even see 5 feet in front of your face. You have to wait till like the sun comes out to kind of get an idea where this is a farm, this is a field and stuff like that. It kind of gives you more authenticity. There's the Chancellorsville house. And if you didn't put anybody there, I can flank them. Like real nice. Is that Union? What the heck is that? Oh, I thought that was a Union. It's a burned down fence. How's my attack going out over here? Doing pretty well, actually. Doing pretty well, actually. Very good. We're about to get flanked, though. You? Pretty well. So, as you can see, guys, this is the game. There's a lot more scenarios that you can play and battle. Yeah. looking at some battle details. Our casualties, we took 1,247, enemy casualties, 888. But as you can see, there's a lot of... And you could play... I really like Antietam. The real cool thing about Antietam is you play Confederate or Union the whole day. Let's play the Union a little bit. Just want to give you guys a little scope on here with a knight. But honestly, you know, if Scourge of War came out with another rendition of their games for the Civil War, with an updated engine, updated graphics, and challenge, I'll be honest, it's going to blow Ultimate General Civil War out of the ballpark. Because the only thing right now is the command and control, the graphics, the few things that I mentioned. And maybe the map. This map needs to be a little bit more easier to read. And one thing that I mentioned in my review is, if I can order units, if I could just like select these units and just drag them here on this map, this would be a lot easier. That would be one thing that I would love. But as you can see, it's dark. I can't even move my guys. So this probably would be not a good time to move men. You know, I'm like, I can't even see 5 feet in front of my face. You know, I know what this is, but beyond that, you know, it's dark. You know, that's one real cool thing about the game. You kind of want to like say, all right, well, let's wait for morning. It's going to be in 15 minutes or something like that. So let's wait for there. He has 18,000 men on him? I guess more men are going to come into the battle. You can go here. Oh, this is the wheat field. Yeah, the wheat field, my friends. Where's the Union? Where are my guys? Bloody. South. So you gotta use that compass. That's key. I'm gonna use you guys as my recon. Recon. But let's fast forward. Let's get faster fast forwards. Alright. So as you can see the transition. The ribs. I see them. They coming. They coming. We coming for them. There they are. We coming for you. We coming. And they're forming up. There's a lot of them too. Alright, here we go. See if we can get out of this bloody wheat field. A nice aerial view of here. I got a couple of brigades here, artillery. So basically, this is the game. I really like it. If you kind of like between both games, I would recommend Scourge of War. Unfortunately, like this is a game that doesn't piss me off. You know, I've been playing this game for what 15, 20 minutes, whatever maybe, and I'm kind of like, you know, I'm not pissed off. You know, I'm not cursing. You know, so that's a good thing. You know. You know, it's also little things like they crafted the map, the state flags onto each unit here. So they're different, as you can see, going through the units. Double quick. You're gonna shoot. The train's probably not. Oh, there we go. I lost a couple guys. I lost one. They're bringing up two brigades. Look at that. That's not too bad. That's good. The graphics are, you know, pretty decent. All right, guys, so that's gonna do it for me, guys. Pardon for this video. Yeah, so this way you can compare. Maybe I'll make this as one big bunched up video between Ultimate General Civil War and Scourge of War Civil War. I mean, Scourge of War, Chancellorsville, and Antietam. So, catch you in the next video, guys. See you then.